Inside NeoLoad Web, we've got a completed set of results. Looking at the Overview tab, we can see information about how long the test ran for, the number of virtual users that were running at any point in time. You've also got information about throughput, so how many requests per second took place, what the response time looked like, and so on. Scrolling down in the summary information, you can see the start time, stop time of the test, the duration of the load test, who ran it, and also information about its status, the fact that this one passed, for example. Looking at the values tab, this is the underlying data that constructs those graphs. So information here, for example, based on transactions, we can see the minimum, the maximum, the average response times, how many times that transaction was executed, and if any errors were encountered. We can drill down into this at various levels of granularity. So initially we were looking at transactions. We've now drilled down into requests. And if we want to, we can filter this view by typing in certain keywords. In this example here, we filter it based on API. And you can see information here about all of the posts that went to the API page, again with their minimum, the maximum, the average response times. On the events tab, we see any errors, any thresholds that were exceeded, any SLAs that were broken, and we can filter this information. So for example, if I was to filter this and click on errors, there are no errors in this list. All of the information in this events tab is based on the fact that we exceeded thresholds. So our infrastructure, for example, was struggling. On the SLA tab, assuming that I had SLAs in my load test, you would see the results of those SLAs being displayed here. Again, you can filter the results based on transaction, page, or request, but you can also filter results based on status, whether they failed the SLA, whether there were warnings, or whether the world was good and we passed. Inside NeoLoad Web, just like inside NeoLoad itself, you have the ability to create dashboards. One thing to be aware of here is this first tab that we're viewing is actually shared with us. The padlock icon indicates the fact that it's not our tab, it's being shared to us by another team member. In terms of dashboardings, you can have as many tabs across the top as you like. So for example, with the demo tab, I've got one tab with three different viewlets inside it, all showing me different types of metric. On the new tab, I can start building this one myself. So potentially I can rename it. You will notice here that I've also resized the graph. So this graph board here is stretched to be as long as it can possibly be. And what I want to do here is I want to have different graphics on here. So by clicking on the Add button, I get a new graph view, and on this graph view I can drop and drag various pieces of information. So for example here I'm selecting user paths or transactions, and I want the average duration. I simply drag that metric, drop it onto the tab, and we get that information displayed. There are various levels of granularity like inside NeoLoad. So while I could say all transactions across the entire load test, I can, if I want to, drill down into individual user paths or individual user transactions. I also have the ability to add monitoring information. So not only monitoring for the infrastructure, so load on the web server, load on the app server, for example, I also have the ability to actually plot external data. Now, this is external data that's being pushed into the load test from an external source. This could be the results of a Selenium run. It could be the results of the integration with Dynatrace. Any external data that's pushed into NeoLoad can also be plotted onto these graphs. So in this example here, we are using Dynatrace, and I'm getting Dynatrace metrics and dropping them onto the graph. You will notice here, though, when I did that drag and drop, I can actually plot multiple line items on the same graph. Once I've built a dashboard, I can toggle the sharing switch and I can share it with other team members, just like that graph board was shared with us. I also have the ability to duplicate any of these views or replace the content. Now, by replace, what we simply mean is the fact that I'm currently looking at result set A. I could use the same layout and drop in result set B. The trending charts allow me to view results over time. So they are a summary. They will show me summary of all of the transactions across all of the runs. But what I can see here is I can say for any particular project, for any particular scenario, show me the last 5, 10, 15, 20 results. Now, with the trending chart here, assuming that I'm doing regular load testing, I can start identifying trends. So, did the latest release have an improvement or a degradation? Finally, we have the search capability. In the results inside NeoLoad Web, we can select a particular project, a particular test based on text description, particular execution period, or particular statuses. So I can filter my results based on whatever criteria I need to allow me to drill down and find the results that I'm looking for.